Womp, 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 womp. Wait, are you muted?
Doo-doo-doo.
Oh, there we go. Hey, what's up, everybody? What's going on?
Do you know what this week marks?
What is this week, Mark?
Marks the week that Nate and I both sat down and tried to learn After Effects.
You mean like this week? Yeah.
This week.
Did you guys see the hold on. Did everyone see the cool stinger that we came into? Can I get some fingers in the chat for that? You guys want to see it again?
Sam's mom.
What? We did it.
Yeah,
we both did some shit. How's it going? Trailer boys and trailer girls of the world, I want to say hello to you. My name is Nate Brown. I am the caretaker manager of Trailer Boys. This is my brother Sam. This is the show, Trailer Boys. He's the trailer boy.
Hello.
And I think that's Emily, the trailer girl in the corner.
Hey, wait, let's try this out. If I was like, girls don't make good trailer boys, what would happen on the show?
To her? Or did like people in
chat? No. The other new thing.
Oh, what do you mean? What's the new thing?
The thing that I made.
Oh, we'll get there. We'll get there.
Okay.
That's a surprise. All right. That's a surprise. All right. That's a surprise.
All right. Sorry. Okay.
Sorry. Am I quiet? Am I too quiet? Sam's just loud, guys. We're getting there. Look, sexism
is. Turn me down. You can turn me down on the Discord.
I'll turn it down. Everybody, if you're not familiar with the show, we watch trailers and talk some shit and give out points. All the trailers come from you guys, the watchers of the show, the trailer boys and trailer girls. So without you guys, there is no show. So we do appreciate you submitting your trailers. Okay. And so we also want to point out that the theme of the show this week for the submissions was bad moms, because it's Mother's Day. It is Mother's Day. Timmy may be coming, so we have a special guest for the Trailer Boys show tonight.
The original bad mom herself.
Hold on. Oh, there we go. Oh, it's all.
What? What happened?
Hey, mom. What? Get off the dang roof.
Can you hear her?
Yeah. Yeah,
the headphones. Can hear you.
Oh. Wait, I'm trying to brush my hair. I just got a shower.
Jeez.
Okay, everybody, our special guest tonight is our mom, because it's Mother's Day and we're not able to spend it with her in person. We are spending it with her virtually. And actually, I guess we get some quality time in doing tech support for the last 6 hours trying to get this together.
Yeah.
So that kind of works, right? As some quality Mother's Day time. So the next thing we could really deal with is...
Here we go.
You didn't even tell me how to do that, and I figured it out.
I was hoping Kathy's hair
looks good.
From the million other things that we tried to do.
We did do a lot of things.
That was, yeah. One thing that was funny was earlier I got her to install Discord. And while she was installing Discord, she's like, I can just go on the website and hit login. And I'm like, no, that's not what we're doing. And then, later she's like, all right, I'm in. She couldn't get her video up. And Nate finally called her and was like, all right, hold your phone up to the screen. And he goes, all right, you're in the website.
Chat's saying quiet, if she can be turned up.
Me?
Nate, can you turn mom up?
Words that have never been said before.
Just speak louder. Speak in your normal voice.
I am speaking. Do you want me to be, where is the mic for, it's in my earbuds, which I fixed, by the way.
Yep.
All right. Am I okay now?
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
I don't know, Chad. Goddamn, Chad.
What?
Nothing.
Do you want me to talk louder? I can talk louder.
Talk with your normal volume.
Okay, this is my normal volume.
That's not okay. You're being polite for the crowd.
This is my normal volume.
Okay, 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 everyone. Okay, everyone.
Tell stories?
No, we're not telling stories.
All right.
No. Marth, we have, right, and you've seen the video.
Trailer Boys.
Trailer Boys is over.
Yes, that was it. It's a quick show, Mom.
Yep. So, Mom, I don't think we've ever even told you we do a show. There's literally tens of people watching right now. So be on your best behavior. So here's the thing. If you're new to Trailer Boys, because we get new people every week, and I send this out to all my friends, and none of them watch. So if you're in chat, you're my friend. Give me ones. Ones in chat. Let me say this. Last week, I didn't think we would have a winner. I was kind of sad. I was like, I don't know if we have a winner. And then some trailer came through, and it blew my mind. And it was a new submitter too, I think, right?
I think so.
Let me see. It was somebody that hasn't been on the board before, and they came in hard. They came hard.
Did you guys explain to Mom how this show works?
We're doing that now. We're explaining it.
So, okay.
I kind of figured that.
You know, we're explaining to everybody. Pretty much points don't matter, and we give people points. Oh, wait, no. Flanja submitted Highway to Hell. Sorry, Flanja. You're definitely in the crew. Highway to Hell won, right? Did that win?
Yeah.
Okay.
So yeah, Highway. Yeah,
didn't mark it as a winner. I didn't.
The crazy thing with Highway. Crazy thing with Highway to Hell is there's a line in it that's there's a deranged ice cream man in the trailer that says, "I'm gonna scoop your brains," and the cartoon I'm writing, we wrote an episode with the deranged ice cream man who goes around saying, "I'm going to scoop your brains to people." And none of us have seen this movie.
Yes. So we're going to watch it just to recap for everybody. What was the cool shit going on last week? And so we can get some audio so you guys can tell us what it sounds like. I do want to give a shout out Future Reunion Tour with the cool logo graphics here, up there with the Cinerama Drome. Can't do it. Lego Blad 3 or Lego Blade. You can respectfully address my mother, however, she's heard it all. I don't think she can be grossed out. And she's a nurse, so she's seen a bunch of gross shit. Also, shout out to the crazy saxophonist who keeps the scrolls, which is like the submission form. If you do want to submit, please go to miseryloves.us. Let me see her. Am I gonna do this right? Okay. Fucking A. We did one thing right. That's two things. All right, guys. Let's start this. Okay, can you see this, Mom, on the YouTube windows?
I can. I turn the sound off.
Oh, you could turn it up now that you're on the phone, okay, but just don't be cranking it. All right, let's go.
We were talking about that sound
thing. Hey, yo.
Join us on a dazzling cinematic adventure down the highway to hell. A winding route that stretches from here to eternity.
Is it working?
Can you see it?
Discover the warm,
is the movie playing?
Energetic, inventive, and friendly inhabitants.
You can't see the
hell.
Movie?
Are you looking at the Discord, or are you looking at that YouTube thing?
No, YouTube.
Okay, there we go. Just keep watching it.
Just getting...
And delicious.
Ben Stiller.
Vegetarian bitch!
Paging Saddam Hussein.
Down here. That's a compliment.
You'll marvel at the unusual flora and fauna. Delight in the people's daily pursuits.
I'm a lover, not a fighter.
Is it going now?
Yeah.
No, it's not.
Okay, we'll get you on the next one. Yeah, we'll get you on the next one.
Okay.
Once you're across,
just stay right there.
There's no way back.
Okay. It looks like I'm the only one. Right now.
Our people steeped in tradition.
Oh, Kathy, close that one you're at. Go back to your email. Click the link I sent you an email.
The other, the same link?
Same link.
Okay.
The international hotspot it is today.
I am the Prince of Princes.
We've heard that story before, haven't we?
Highway to Hell.
Awesome titles. Like the title design.
The graphics for the title. Yeah. Is that what you're talking about?
We'll have some fun.
Yeah.
Unforgettable journey from Sovereign Pictures.
Now we'll have some fun.
Not far enough.
Yeah, I went back not far enough. There we go.
It is today.
I'm still learning like the key commands.
The Prince
you know?
Of Princes.
We've heard that story before, haven't we?
Highway.
Damn. That looks great.
That is cool. I wonder if that was like a professional graphic designer or like somebody that was friends with the production.
I'm going to steal that font.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool. You know what? I feel it.
Nate, remind me to steal
it's
that
like
font.
It's like a Kandinsky.
I liked the trailer.
Yeah.
It was a good trailer.
Out of nowhere.
Really good.
It was like, oh, this movie's cool. I think our friend put it on his server.
Oh, that's who submitted it?
No.
Submitted. Oh, cool.
I showed him that trailer, and he was like, oh.
I do want to give a shout out to
we're gonna watch it then.
DJ Knife. And I personally am sponsored by the Strange Brew Coffee IPA tonight from Bent Long Brewing Company. So shout out for dropping off beer. Now she's watching it.
Now we'll have some fun,
you guys.
I need specific directions. Hey, that's okay. I'm not using sound.
You can use sound.
Oh well, you know.
Okay. So that was
brought to you by Trader Joe's sparkling blueberry lemonade flavored water.
Coffee. Anyway.
All right. Now I'm connected. So, what? Okay. Now.
Right now, I'm like pumped that we've gotten this far. Okay. If the show's done now, I'm into it. Allegra G says, Trailer Boy's favorite. I hope you've had such a fantastic day. Happy Mother's Day, Kathy.
So nice. Thank you.
She's wicked nice. She just graduated from some type of school.
Awesome. Very nice. Congratulations on your graduation. It was a rough year.
Don't pander to her.
All right. Whatever.
You don't know her. She's a stranger to you. All right. Sam.
Okay.
Let me just tell everyone that one got, I think, like 4 points, but because it won, it got way more points.
I thought it got 6 points.
It got 8 points, I think. Or maybe, did it get 6 points off the bat?
I thought it got 2 points from the audience, 2 points from you, 2 points from me.
Yeah, but then because it won, it got 2 more points. So let me tell chat, you guys are going to be also voting on this. So I think what that means is chat gets 2 points. And then the four of us each get 1 point.
Okay.
Wow.
How do I get points? Because I like to win things.
No, you have to give points. You give points. You're a judge, Mom.
You know what? I'll give Kathy a point for that trailer. Kathy a point.
Mom gets a point from Emily.
Kathy gets a point from me. That was amazing. She needs a point.
So Crazy Sax, can you write down that my mom has 1 point?
I don't think Sax is here. All right. You've won is 2 great sons. Sam, why don't you load us up? Get us into the next.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Sam, I would appreciate if you and Emily could control the movies, and I'll control the polls in chat to make sure we're all flowing. All right.
All right. Cool.
If it's going well. It's me clicking. If it's going poorly, it's Sam clicking.
All right. I got two new trailers this week. One's going to be fun to watch. One's interesting, but kind of a downer.
Okay. Oh, wait, is this Coming Attractions?
This is Coming Attractions.
All right, hold on. I think I know.
Felt normally.
Because nothing's coming up on my screen.
No, he's running something in the.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Oh, wait. Oh, crap.
That doesn't sound good.
This was what I was.
Now, I don't want to get your hopes up.
I
there's a good IT program in the area, and I'd be glad
copied
to make
the video and.
What if I don't want to?
I copied a video of a bunch of trailers.
Oh, that's
I just think
I
it's
see.
More practical
like
for someone,
trailers?
A young lady in your situation.
Is this a bummer? It feels like a bummer.
This one's kind of a bummer, but
this seems funny.
It looks good.
Manufacturing drying up left and right.
What's going on?
They closed us down.
I love her. That
you get a front row
right?
seat to how the world works.
I didn't see anything.
Y'all need some professor of sociology quiz of me. On life below the poverty line.
What was she from?
She's smart here, trust me.
What does that mean?
It means here at least you can see the top.
Oh my God.
What?
You just got into college.
Have a life here.
That's some life here, huh?
You can't see it?
No.
Move fast, follow the wire.
It's the same window that the last trailer was in.
Gold mines.
I know, but there's
sounds
nothing
illegal.
But,
you know, I'm not slow, honey. I know what you've been doing.
Like
what about
please?
Please ask questions.
Okay. How about we have you hit play on the next one?
You stay in this town because you're scared. Scared to call. I'm scared to leave.
You stay here because you're weak.
The best beginner-friendly
user. Does it say, connected users? Does it say NSK?
Correct.
Damn it, Bobby.
Why don't you leave, Ruth? Just take my keys and go.
I'll never see this movie. Not out of spite or anything. But...
Right now, puberty.
Wait, oh, hold on, hey, hold on. Is this the next one you're watching?
No. I have a different trailer. That was just
put the trailer in and then hit play, pause, and then have Mom hit play on it. Mom, you ready for
okay.
that?
Go ahead.
This is going great, guys.
KO8971 says, these movies are cool for rich people, but they fucking suck for people who live that shit. And I agree with you. You're like, cool. That's a cool story that like is entertaining other people. All right, Mom, do you see the thing in the thing? It looks like a school and a kid with a backpack.
No,
what do you see? What do you see?
I see something that says Little Nicky, the best beginner friendly yeast bread.
Okay, that's your YouTube suggestions. Hit the reload button.
Okay, replay or what's reload?
It's like replay? A circle with an arrow pointing to itself.
Yeah,
it's like a circular okay. arrow next to a house.
Okay, all right. Yeah. Oh, I'm getting that nasty ring thing going on. All right, let me try something else. You guys keep going along with the show. I'll fix it.
You are part
Duffy
of the show.
Duffy 3 says, welcome back to Moms on the Internet.
Oh, my God, that's good. Wait a minute.
So did
you hit reload? And then what does it say now?
No, you know what happened? It keeps losing the Wi-Fi.
Oh.
Which is what
sucks.
Happened when I was in my board meeting. Oh, I got it.
Oh, okay.
These cars. Is that... All right. Oh, it's Highway to Hell.
Okay, shit. Reloaded again.
I know.
Or maybe. Whew.
I can pull it. I'll pull it till the end.
What?
Sam, now she's at Highway to Hell. try and put the link in again and hit play.
Game Ben?
Already started a new one.
Oh, my name's Troy Mayfield. I love making video games. My mom and dad started a gaming company, and all I've ever wanted to do is work there.
Zach and Cody!
PixelCon is 20.
It's your Game Ben?
Already started a new one.
My name's
I love. What are you looking at?
I love making video games.
Game Ben?
Already started a new one.
It looked like a bad date I had once with. And they shot him and he fell in the bed.
Okay, we're definitely in two different nights. shit. All right.
Also, you had a bad date where someone got shot into a bed.
Into a bed, and he had horns. I don't know, the ice cream man.
You're still watching Highway to Hell.
I'm sweating now. Okay, close that browser window. Close the browser window. Click the link in the email one more time for us.
Okay.
And then when you get there and you see the thing, let me know.
Okay. Okay. Because then I have to. Okay, I'm sorry, guys.
No. Don't apologize. Oh. Okay. Do you see it? Hold on, Sam. Hold on. Let me do it. Let me do it.
Yeah, Sam, you do it.
Mom, do you see it?
You look gorgeous.
Okay.
Your hair looks so good.
It just said can't be part it.
You look good.
Why did I do that? That's you.
Oh, she's seeing it.
That was a gift for chat. Thank you guys for bearing with us. I appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you guys bearing with us. Sam, let's do it.
Is your Game Ben?
Already started a new one.
My name's Troy Mayfield. I love making video games. My mom and dad started a gaming company, and all I've ever wanted to do is work there.
Zach and Cody!
PixelCon is 20 days away.
I've literally never been more excited for a video game than I am for Exodus' Alien Repo.
The inside scoop on Playfield's latest game, it is not good, friends. They ditched their game, they ditched their lead designer. Good luck, you're gonna need it.
I was wondering if you might be interested in
buying out your games.
Yeah, I would do that for you.
P.S. There would not be jobs here for any of your employees, of course.
Mom, let me come and help. I'm actually really good at this.
His mom's like the head of the company. Oh, I love the spinning
Everyone
around hacker
scenes. Everyone has been working weeks to try and fix those glitches that you managed to fix in one night. That's why I am putting you in charge of it.
He's in
are
high
you
school.
Out of your mind?
We are out of time.
She's crazy.
She's insane.
Holy crap! It happened. This really happened.
Yeah. That's the guy from Genie.
Have you guys ever thought of maybe dancing like somebody is watching?
I need some time to think and work on my own. They're just gonna slow me down. This is the only job I've ever had. I helped build this company. I have my own family now.
The longer we let Gandalf lead us, the greater chances we're gonna lose everything.
Everyone's falling so far behind.
I've never seen you ask for help.
We need to find something that real gamers really want to play.
When I'm coding, I see a whole other world.
Me too.
What do you guys think?
You're asking us?
Yeah, we're all Playfield Games, right?
Let's show the world what we can do. I, for one, never doubted you. I doubted you 100%.
BRB.
LOL.
This is great.
I like how the movie feels like it's about video games, but written about the old people who are trying to make video games in the movie. Like it's people that have never seen a video game before.
Yeah.
That is so weird. It's not even out yet. That's awful.
I love when they do like movies about like programmers or like nerd subculture. Like they never get it wrong. Yeah. It's always a miss. I mean, it's always a hit. They crush it every time.
Yeah, it's always correct. Yeah.
Every time. Perfect.
It's very accurate. Like, it's funny because I feel like the people make the movies, they write the movies, and then they're like, when they finally see what like real, like, you know, computer programming, game programming, they're like, no, we can't have it like that. We need to have them spinning around with computer graphics and stuff.
That's not it.
Grandma's Boy was great, but not for the computer programming parts. They were like, remember in Grandma's Boy? It was like, I got to do these levels tonight, man. I can't. I got levels to do. Yeah.
I've got to write Mario tonight. I've got to write all the Mario. I have to put 10 more power-ups and a warp zone into this thing.
Yeah. It's not like they don't show anybody like sleeping at their desk.
How long ago did they actually film that, though? I mean, that was not filmed last year, obviously. So it's probably from 2018, 2019. Considering
that's the one thing they filmed during COVID. Yeah. They said it's got to get made.
Yeah. We must make the film.
Yeah. Got to get made. These children are going to be at risk, but it's worth it.
You don't understand.
Okay.
I like how he's like the teenager, and also somehow there's like another teenager that's working at the company.
Yeah.
I think that was his best friend, and in his contract he was like, no, Mom, I won't work for you unless...
No. The girl. The girl. Yeah.
It's so he can have a love interest. She's an intern. Duh.
Oh, yeah. She was...
Come on, guys. Do I have to write this movie?
Yeah. I sounds like you are.
I did. Don't look it up. I wrote it.
So that was Coming Attractions.
Yay. Mm. Let me do the thing again.
That was good.
Let me sting her out of Coming Attractions.
Did you nominate that? That was good.
That's Sam's segment.
That's good.
Video game company uses child slave labor to make video games and get crunch time approval. Crunch time approval.
the movie.
That was good, Tazu.
Tazu for you. That's good.
That's a point. Sam, why don't we start the show?
Yeah.
No.
Now we're getting into like the points thing.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
And so, chat, remember, you guys are responsible for 2 points a movie. If it's like doing nothing for you, 1 point. If you're like, this should be considered for, you know, this is worth noting, that's a point. If you're like, this should be considered for trailer of the week, 2 points. That's what you're voting on. Okay, guys? And you let me down last week. And I think some of you should. You know, we have really bad taste.
All right, I'm going to start out slow. Not necessarily slow, but with something a lot of us have seen, but should be a fun trailer.
We forgot to tell Mom what the theme was.
Mothers?
Sure.
A kind of mothers.
Uh-oh.
The theme today is bad moms.
And let's hit play.
You've got to get it through your thick head. I may be a lot of things,
Who submitted
this?
Don't
have to blow her brains out or anything.
Thank you. That takes the pressure right off.
She's old.
This is from Zombie Bender.
All you got to do is jerk around a lot when you talk to her. Top three. Nice to meet you, Mrs. Liff.
Stop it. Aaron, what the hell's going on out there?
We woke her up.
Look how much
hair. Nothing, Mama.
Oh, so good.
Who's this?
Oh, I love that.
This is Cousin Patty. He's going to be staying with us for a while. Isn't that nice?
You don't have a Cousin Patty.
You lied to me.
Weird version of the trailer. That's not the trailer I've seen before.
That was a cool trailer.
That was really artistic.
Yeah, I feel like they really captured the movie and like
they just showed a bit of scene. Get a longer cord, silly head.
Ow.
I'll buy you one.
Man, I really liked that. And I forgot about that movie.
I really liked that too.
I've never seen that movie, but I know it's one of my favorites. You know what I mean?
Yeah. It's
Like, I haven't seen it, but I know it's one of my favorites.
Well, it's a comedic version of Alfred Hitchcock's Strangers on a Train.
Yeah.
Really?
You say that about every trailer we watch.
Who wrote and directed that movie?
I should have
the IMDb scene up, but I don't think I have it up. The trailer girls are trailer boys. You know what? I'm going to give that.
Danny DeVito directed it.
Man.
Good for really him. Good,
he was pretty funny.
Yeah.
He had a lot of hair. I'm going to give that a point.
Written by Steve Silver.
That gets
a point. I'm giving that a point.
As a trailer, I think that was good. I like that it was concise and it gave you enough where you're like, okay, I get it. You know?
Get the whole deal.
Didn't give it away. What is the and there was even to give points?
There's a good gag in it. I mean, the "you lied to me" gag.
Yeah.
That's great.
That was great.
Yeah, that's funny.
Great. So, Kathy Brown, do you give it a point?
And is it an ongoing, that fry pan thing? I think it's ongoing in that movie, too. The fry pan.
We're judging the trailer.
All right. Okay. Yeah. I'll Whoa. Give it a point. Can I get, is it my only point? Can I give other things a point?
Leprechaun Flute just went off with some gifted subs.
Oh, whoa. Hey. Thank you, Leprechaun
Very
Flute.
Very nice.
That's
a lot.
We give points every trailer. All right. So it looks like the chat is leaning at one point. I'm giving it 1 point. KB?
Yes. 1 point.
1 point.
1 point.
I think that's a 5-point trailer.
I think that's a 5-point trailer. And you know what that means, guys? That puts it in there. I don't know if Sax is with us tonight, so I'm going to try and find that and fix that. Oh, wait. Oof.
Okay.
And that was from Zombie Bender.
All right, this is...
Okay.
We'll stick with the genre here. And similar time period.
Another DeVito-directed movie?
I don't know who directed this one. It's not Danny DeVito, but...
Oh, I was like, it's that closely related. It might also be directed by Danny DeVito.
How about 7 o'clock? I'll pick you up, but...
R.I.P. J.C. Yeah.
With the stiffs?
Danny loves Jason.
Oh, I saw that.
Yeah!
Yeah,
yeah, just got lucky in there
I'm
with a girl.
That, actually,
it's not what you're thinking. She does everybody in there. Not in that way.
Teresa loves Danny.
I would really like to go out with you again.
He doesn't have to go chasing some ghoul from a funeral parlor for a date.
Rose loves Danny.
Good night, son.
Catherine.
Oh, he's got a girl. Gee.
Who died and left you an opinion?
Nick loves Rose.
Greek men are great lovers.
Wow. Greek men never fade.
She's just playing hard to get.
Come to her bed.
She's been hard to get for 20 years. That's really hard to get.
And Sal loves just about anyone.
She thinks I'm getting weird in bed.
Are you?
It's only the beginning of Only the Lonely.
Where are her breasts?
Ma.
You're built like a 13-year-old boy.
Clean that stomach.
I'm not feeling anything of yours.
You were planning this.
No, I didn't expect you to just come in here and, you know... Jumping in, I know.
So, was she good in the sack or what?
Daddy?
Oh my God, it's my mom. Come on, hurry up. Okay.
20th Century Fox presents John Candy.
I'm getting romantic advice from a widow and two bachelors.
Maureen O'Hara.
He's always trying to look under my skirt when I cross my legs.
Ally Sheehan.
Maybe I'll gain some weight and grow breasts for you.
James Belushi.
It wasn't a sexual problem, was it? I mean, you can function as a man, all right?
I'm going to sleep.
And Anthony Quinn.
At last, we get to sleep.
Is that Ally Sheedy? So what they're
saying? Yeah.
Romantic comedy.
From The Breakfast Club, huh?
From John Hughes and Chris Columbus.
Oh, it's a John Hughes with the Lone Boy.
Oh. See, got kind of close. Oh, directed by Chris Columbus, yeah.
Oh.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm thinking of a different Chris Columbus.
You're thinking of the sailor. Yeah, he was dead by then. He never.
The colonizer.
I was picturing Chris Christopherson.
Oh.
So I'm way.
Yeah, no.
Who submitted that one, Sam?
That was a good one.
I like those. I think that was also like, it wasn't like as artistic as the Throw Mama from the Train trailer, but it like, it still was a fun trailer. Had a lot of good moments, told me what the movie was, didn't necessarily show the whole thing, but I'm suspecting that the movie ends at a Cubs game. That was from Avalanche Fan 84.
Nice.
Very good.
Chris Columbus Avalanche. Also directed Home Alone.
Yeah.
And was not a cool guy to Native Americans, apparently. Even the director. Oh, nope. The director. Okay, here's my thing, guys. I like John Candy. Jim Belushi's, I mean, he kind of looked like a douchey guy in that movie, so I guess that's on par, right? I'm not going to give it a point.
Okay.
Let's see where chat's leading. What are you guys thinking?
I'm going to give it a point because everybody thinks that I said John Candy wasn't funny when I gave a speech about how Canadians aren't funny. But I didn't say that. I didn't say anything about John Candy because I'm friends with his daughter. I actually do think he's funny, but because I'm friends with his daughter, I just didn't talk about him because it just makes me sad.
Because you were doing a bit. So I actually didn't talk.
I was doing a bit about how Canadians aren't funny. And then everybody was like, in the chat tonight, was like, see, Emily, he's funny. And I was like, I didn't talk about him. I never specifically named him. I'm friends with his child. And it just made me too sad to even think about or talk about because he was so great.
All right. So chat's with me on this. That's two goose eggs.
I'll give a point for that, though, because I feel bad.
Okay. I'll give a point. You guys missed.
For all the Canadians out there, there's a point.
A good bit that you guys kind of talked over and missed, which is him excitedly jumping outside of the funeral home and the funeral procession looking at him and goes, oh, I just got lucky in there. And they're like, no.
Yeah.
And they look at him like he had sex with a dead person. And he's like, no, with the mortician. She
knows everybody.
She knows everybody. Yeah.
You know, I feel like if I was a pallbearer, though, and I'm like literally walking a casket into a thing that's got an American flag on it, and some guy's like, hey, I just fucked a dead body in there. Like, I literally am like, I got too much other shit going on. Go for it, dude. My dead body buddy is right next to me. I don't give a shit what you're doing. You're also a cop, so I assumed you did something fucked up in there. Fuck off. So, anyway. That's 2 points for the trailer duo. Now it comes down to KB.
I don't know. I'm not really sure. No, I'm judging the trailer as it stands alone. Not really.
The points don't matter. You don't have to think too deep about it.
Enough about the movie? All right. No, because
it's a real Sophie's choice here, huh?
It sounds like you're leaning like you don't want to give it a point.
Well, yeah, because I don't believe the movie.
Believe the movie?
No.
I heard you say that while we were watching it. You were like, I don't believe this. I'll tell you right now, it didn't happen.
It didn't.
That's my point. It didn't happen.
Yeah, a lot of these didn't happen.
I know, but that one really didn't happen.
Every movie that doesn't say based on a true story, she's like, this didn't happen. It didn't say based on a true story at the beginning.
No.
Do you know a movie really didn't happen? Star Wars? That, like, whoa, that super didn't happen.
But the yellow text in the beginning of Star Wars made it sound like it was real. It was a galaxy far, far away.
In my head, Star Wars, it could have happened, but that movie, no, that
Mom, Star Wars couldn't have happened.
It could have happened in a galaxy.
In my head, it maybe could have happened, you know?
Okay.
It was far, far away.
Suspension of disbelief.
No. All right.
She is more apt to believe Star Wars could happen than this, than John Candy dating Ally Sheedy. Okay. Got it.
Well, then also cruel. Belushi as a cop was kind of like a stretch.
Oh, Jim Belushi as a cop I could buy.
Yeah, that couldn't happen.
That was kind of creepy.
Yeah.
He's too creepy. Mom, with the hair.
If John Belushi wasn't famous, Jim Belushi probably would have been a cop.
That's a fact. That's a fucking fact.
Not okay. A good
That's
one,
totally true.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay. All right.
So all right. I got another trailer.
All right, go.
You ready?
Ready. Ooh, it loaded.
This is where the worst begins.
Ooh, I like the voiceover.
This is where we must stop. For beyond is the work of madness.
Death!
The nightmare of insane murder and lingering death. Deranged.
Ooh, I like the title.
For Mary, it was only the beginning.
Uh-oh.
For Christine, it was already too late.
Yeah.
Dolly, the worst was yet to come.
Sorry, Christine.
And only Mrs. Cobb knew what he would do next.
I really love you, Mary.
Ew, creepy.
He said he loved her.
That's sweet. Must be his wife.
Lisa's girlfriend.
Is that a real
Sometimes you don't want to believe what you see. But sometimes it's true. The story of a trail of butchery so brutal that newspapers refuse to print its horrifying details. When the horror becomes unbearable, it is too late to scream.
He said it was in the newspaper.
That was fucking dope.
Yo. All right, that was rad. That was from Kit Black. The story is
74. Wow.
That girl was his mom. That's why it's mom related. And she was a bad mom. She ran.
It's more a bad son than a bad mom. I guess the full title is Deranged Confessions of a Necrophile. Ooh, and it's a deranged rural farmer becomes a grave robber and murderer after the death of his possessive mother, whose corpse he keeps, among others, as his companion in a decaying farmhouse.
So broke down psycho. All right.
Uh-oh.
It was kind of like a Texas Chainsaw Massacre psycho kind of mishmash.
Kind of psycho.
Yeah.
I think, exactly. But aren't they? They're both based on Gein, right?
Yeah. Yeah. Ed Gein. Really? Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
So it makes sense.
Based so closely on the true story of Ed Gein.
See?
So yeah. Yeah. No,
I know,
and that's
serial killers.
That's part of the reason that I picked it is because mom, that one was true.
I totally like that was so creepy, realistic-y kind of stuff in the trailer, and it will give me nightmares. So I'd give it a one.
Ooh, Kathy, throwing points out for the movie's little scary.
Oh, look who it is!
Hold on. Let me get to this.
What's up?
And here. Wait. No.
Hey everybody. Hi.
Hold on one sec, guys.
Hey Kathy, happy Mother's Day.
Thank you, babe. How are you?
Good. Very good. You're definitely on my list of other moms, you know that? So
I missed that.
What does that mean, other moms?
You know, other moms. You don't have other moms? Kathy, you
of
know
your,
what?
Like your other moms.
You know what? She knew what I meant, so I don't care about you guys.
Like Buzz.
I do.
And then, like, you know, there's my mom. There's my friend Casey's mom. There's Sam's mom. There's, Kathy. I'm not trying to talk about you like you're not here.
Oh, no,
you
know. No. I get it.
What did these guys get you besides making it on your show?
Sam Brown got me some Tuscan herbs and a lovely wheel of imported Italian cheese, which is awesome, and imported Italian olive oil, which is amazing because I was thinking about marinating sheep, like Italian sheep pecorino, is it, or Parmesan?
Wow.
And so yeah, now I get all that. Pecorino. So, yeah.
That is fancy.
And that's also for me.
And
that's also for me.
Yeah.
Well, there you go. So,
and the other half of the gift is the gift of life that you gave me. Thank you.
That's what I gave you. That's
some real cheap shit.
Shut up, Jimmy. Let me ask you this. Since when is Mother's Day the first Sunday of May?
Like all the time.
All the time? Really?
Second Sunday in May, though.
Is it the second Sunday?
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Damn, I thought I had another week. Anyway, my gift is still in the mail, Mom, and it's not here yet.
That's fine. I don't care.
Lives in another state.
Dude, I sent a Mother's Day gift up with plenty of time to get there by today, and it's still in the mail, too. It happens.
Oh, no. Yeah, see, Mom? Yeah.
I ordered a pair of shoes from China. And it got here in 5 days.
So when he says he's ready, it changed.
How weird is that?
The mail is crazy, dude. It's like you can, I can send something.
Okay. Sam, how many points are you going to give that one real quick?
What'd you guys watch?
Sam's going to give it one.
That was rad as hell. And that was 1974. Is that before Texas Chainsaw Massacre?
I think Texas Chainsaw is 74. What did you guys just watch?
Deranged.
It looked rad as hell.
Yeah,
it really?
Was
cool.
It was creepy.
So, Emily,
Texas Chainsaw is also 74.
Oh, what?
Oh,
Emily,
wow.
It's your point now. How many points are you giving that?
I'm gonna give that 1 point because Kathy said it scared me.
Yo, motherfuckers, that's a sweep. Kit Black coming on the board. Kit, is this your first time up here? It might be, bro. Kit Black submitted that. Kit Black in chat submitted that one.
Oh,
deranged. Deranged.
And that's sort of a.
And now,
do you have a link
now,
to the two from chart
74?
What's that, bud?
Do you have a link to the chart?
Yeah, I'll email it to you. You know what, Timmy? It might be shared with you in your
Google Docs.
You know what? Let me Google Docs share it with you real quick. Mom, why don't you tell chat your, you know, everyone's like, oh, you know, you're a mom. But in college, you went to UT Austin and you worked at an indie movie theater.
I did.
So you've seen some crazy shit movies, right?
Yeah. The New York Erotic Film Festival. Where I almost got arrested for selling tickets to it. And I didn't watch it. I was just selling the tickets. And the guy who owned the theater actually put up bail money where they could get it because they were expecting the police to come arrest us. It was kind of going to be a big deal. And it didn't happen. I didn't get arrested. But then we had a award. Andy Warhol film, I think it was, or it might have been a John Waters, one or the other. It was the one where the dog ate the poop, Pink Flamingos.
First ate the dog
police
poop?
Came back.
Yeah. The dog doesn't eat the poop, Kathy. A person eats the poop.
A person.
Divine
eats the dog poop. Dog poop. I was like, oh, Kathy, no, a person eats that poop.
Yeah, Pink Flamingos.
Oh, a person.
It's wild.
And so the police did come back for that one. And they came out like, and they're like, yeah, if somebody was able to sit through the first half of that movie, they deserve to see that guy. Or it was a woman, a trans.
It was a drag queen.
Transvestite.
Divine, yeah.
Yeah, it was a drag queen. The Divine, Lady Divine, I think her name was.
Divine.
That they deserve to see her eat the poop. So it's kind of fun to see how what they had to go through to get the dog to poop so that she could eat it. Like, it took days for that whole scene to happen. It was really kind of cool. Then the most awesome thing is, so that was a John Waters film. When Nathan and Sam were in high school, John Waters was getting an award in P-Town, and we were able to go to a lecture that he was giving, and the boys got to meet him. Which
we were in fucking high school.
That's
by
crazy.
The way. We're like, I'm like 15, Sam's like 13 or 12, and you know, we've seen John Waters movies. Continue. Sorry.
What? Me?
Oh, yeah. Continue the story.
No, that's all right. Oh. You met him. He kind of had eyes for you and your brother.
Yeah, that's he was really flirty.
About me. He was flirting with the boys. And I'm like, oh my God, I almost got arrested for your movie, blah, blah, blah. And he's like, yeah. Okay. Hi, boys. Come on. Let's have a picture together.
He was like, sit on my lap. We'll take a photo together.
And then one more step. Sam was with them on stage at the independent awards. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Because I think these are going to go out. At the Independent Spirit Awards, Sam was on stage with John Waters.
So he was?
Yeah.
Timmy, you were there
too. You were there, Tim.
Yeah. Wait, was that the year that I was on a bunch of drugs, though?
Oh,
you guys remember that? I got the emergency appendectomy the night before the Spirit Awards, and your son helped get me to the emergency room. And so, and they sat us the next day. Like, I got out, you know, in time to get to the award show, but I wasn't in the other guys did like a little sketch on stage. And they sat us in the front row in the middle, and I'm like strung out on morphine. And I just remember like sitting there. I've got like a cartoon cat t-shirt on with a suit jacket over. I still got my medical bracelet. And I'm just like sitting in this, like looking up at the front row. And like, I just remember Jason Bateman at one point was presenting an award, and we made eye contact. And I was just like, you know, hair crazy and just like stoned.
There's like a big bottle of Jameson.
Yeah, well, there's all this booze behind me, but I couldn't drink because I was on a bunch of Vicodin and morphine and everything. So I didn't drink anything, but there was tons of booze all around me. And I'm just sitting here, and my table was empty because they were about to perform. So I was the only person sitting at my table. And I'm all just like, you know, and like I lock eyes with Jason Bateman. And he just gives me a split second look, kind of like, okay. Like, who's this guy? Why is he here? You know?
Weren't you guys sitting with one of the executives from IFA?
Yeah, probably. You know, it was one of those like Independent Spirit Awards, but they sit all the corporate people up front, and like the writers and producers and directors are in the back. Which is
but
like,
then you crazy. Could I could see your all's head on the show live.
Yeah, because you guys were right in front.
I was being really first bad, and I was texting Sam, trying to see if he was going to go for his phone to see.
Finally, I was texting Trevor because he laughed at a camera guy that fell over.
What? Yeah. I don't know if that was the first or the second one. We went twice, you know, but
anyway,
the first time I remember Kate Blanchett was there, and she was pregnant, and she was just like this glowing, huge. I mean, she's huge because she's like tall, pregnant angel. She looked just amazing. You know, Kate Blanchett.
It's been a bit since you've been on the show, but remember how we give out points to trailers?
Yeah, a little bit.
Okay, so now that you're here, and Chat, you're involved in this too, because Chat also gives points.
Mm-hmm.
We have 6 points to give, and now including Chat, there's 6 of us. So now, Chat, you get to choose 0 or 1 point. So everyone here, Kathy, Emily, Tim, Timmy.
Okay.
I called you Tim because she called you Tim, and it stuck in my head. I was like, oh, that's
weird.
Oh,
my God.
She called you Tim.
Just don't call me
Tim. What's weird is you call your brother Timmy, and he likes to be called Tim. You call Timmy Tim, and he likes to be called Timmy. Did those die already? Okay. Anyway.
Did they die? Is that right? Can you hear me?
No worries. No worries. So, Timmy, you get 0 or 1 points to give trailers for whatever fucking reason. Trailers don't matter. Points
Yes.
Chat, you're down to 1 or 0 points, guys. You feel me? And again, it's like, if you think this is trailer of the week worthy, give it a point. If you're like, meh, 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 no point. Okay. Emily, I think Sam may have set you up.
I got it, man.
The next trailer. Are we ready? Hold on.
Nope. I'm almost ready.
Okay. Can everyone see it? Timmy, do you see the green?
Where am I looking?
And the YouTube.
Yep, got it.
Kathy.
Wait a minute. It kind of crapped out again. But now I've got it down. All right, when I got it. Yeah.
We're doing it. We're doing it, everyone.
We're doing it. Oh.
Okay. Oh, Timmy, the theme this week is Bad Moms. I don't know if we got that.
And that's
I think
why
I've heard of this movie. I don't know if this is what I'm thinking of.
You don't know this? Oh.
We're ready for you, Miss Crawford.
Oh, please.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Co-hanger.
I've never seen this.
Miss Joan Crawford.
You know what's missing in my life?
Come on. You've got everything you want.
No, I don't. I want a baby.
Out of the question.
Don't you dare judge me. We have a moral and legal responsibility. And what you're really doing is denying one of your children the opportunity to live a wonderful and advantaged life.
You're lucky.
You got a sandwich right there.
And very I don't eat on the street.
Cost me a lot of favors.
Christina, darling.
Did they steal a baby?
Perfect life for you.
Basically. They
you
bought a baby.
Happy birthday, Christina, darling.
This is the best party I ever had.
I love you, Tina, darling. You lost again.
It's not fair. You're bigger than I am.
Ah, but nobody ever said that life was fair, Tina. I will always beat you. And
I'm not going to play
I've heard that before.
Ever. You're going to march yourself upstairs to your
Is she wearing shoulder pads on her swimsuit?
No, I won't. Yes.
It's on the robe.
Hilarious.
But same diff.
Yeah, it was tough, but she found a bathing suit with shoulder pads.
Who is she playing?
Faye Dunaway.
Joan Crawford.
You are not getting up from this table until you have finished that meat.
Have I ever lied to you in your whole career, or given you one piece of bad advice?
And who's Joan Crawford's daughter?
Yeah.
Good.
She's not famous. She just wrote this book.
Wonderful.
Fruit Brute says Faye Dunaway has expressed regret about her performance.
Huh. Really? I thought it was pretty damn good. Although it's very cute.
Box office poison.
Making fun of me? Mayor should know the price I pay.
Truth is, you're getting old.
You're nothing but a rotten, crooked lawyer.
The biggest female star he's got.
Look at this roar. Do you think it's clean? Clean this floor. You and me together. Screw up. Look at that. Nothing is good. What's Wirehanger doing in this closet when
The Kathy Brown story.
$300 dress on a wire hanger. We'll see how many you buy. We're gonna see how many wire hangers you've got in your closet.
Tell me what.
Yes, Mommy dearest.
When I asked you to call me that, I wanted you to mean it.
Oh,
Joan Crawford.
This fucking trailer is sick.
Dude, it's 4 minutes long. Did they give away all the good shit?
Well, you know, in the movie theaters, they were always long.
Yeah.
Dean Koontz. Shit.
Dean Koontz. He's the guy that wrote all those creepy books.
Yeah, he's that guy that's not Stephen King.
Yeah, exactly. So. I don't know.
I've never seen that movie, it gets referenced a lot. So the trailer surpassed my expectations.
It's all very campy.
It's campy. Yeah.
Oh
it's
yeah.
Not bad.
Well, no, yeah. No, it's not a bad thing. That's campy. I mean, yeah. It is campy though. But yeah, I thought it was good. I think it gave away too much, probably.
That's, yeah, I was thinking the same thing.
I want to go back to a scene. These fucking, shoulder pads and the robe.
Yeah, those are nobody ever said. Just like a David Byrne video. I will always beat you. Then I'm not gonna play with you anymore. She looks like one of the prison guards from Ernest Goes to Jail. Life was
fair, Tina. I will always. Nobody said life was fair, David, Kathy Brown.
I wonder.
That's a life lesson.
It's a Kathy Brown life lesson.
Yeah. Look at these fucking shoulder pads. And then she's got her child servant. Wow, guys.
Yeah. That's why you, that's why you have kids, right, Kathy? That's why you have kids, is so they can bring you shit.
Really? For your breakfast. Why out?
What up?
Guys, I'm gonna give that a point because it's for the theme, it's classic.
It definitely hits the
trailer
is
fucking
hard.
Scary as shit. Visually it's You're amazing. Right. The voiceover. I'm going there.
All right. I'm gonna have to. I don't know.
Tim, what do you think, Tim? Now I'm gonna say it all night.
I think I'll give it. I'm kind of wavering. I'll give it 1 point.
You don't have to give it points. If I don't you know don't if I think want it's to. Trailer of the week material, don't give it. A
point. I mean, it's good though.
Oh, well, and Tim, just so you know,
now everyone's calling me Tim.
Tim, just so you know, we all have 1 point. We don't have 2 points.
Right. When you were taking a dump, I told him.
Just 0 or 1.
I wasn't taking a dump. The dog was taking a dump.
It's okay. We all dump. Some more than others.
Everybody dumps.
So Chad is with me on this, giving it a point. Timothy.
I'll give it a point.
I went too deep in the other direction. That's 3 points. Emily.
I think it's a great trailer, but it almost gives you too much of the movie, which is always my complaint.
We have talked about that. Yeah. We have taken points away for that.
Yeah.
That what do you think?
I'm going to not give it a point because it's too long.
Okay, that's also valid.
Too long, too much.
Like, she was a big screen star, but her life was empty because she didn't have a freaking baby, so she kind of bought a baby, and then the baby grew up.
Spoiler!
Was that a true
spoiler?
Huh?
Also, I feel that one was submitted a lot, right? I don't know who submitted it first.
Did you guys get to a Serial Mom? Everybody, I saw that submitted a bunch too.
That got submitted 100 times. We will definitely get there. It looks like Schwingles was the first one to put that one in. Schwingles, congratulations. You were talking shit about not getting picked, and there you go. So that's a point for Chat, a point from Timmy, a point from me, no point from Sam. Kathy Brown?
I'll give it a point begrudgingly because I think it gives you too much information about the movie. Like, why watch the movie?
Emily.
But I'll give it a point because it was well done.
Classic film, classic trailer. Point from me.
Okay. Ooh, that's okay. 5. Wow. Schwingles on the board tonight with a Cinco. See, I was totally messed up. Not only did I forget it was Mother's Day, but I also thought it was like the Cinco de Mayo theme. So I prepped all these like, you know, Spanish movies.
Wow.
Did you find any Spanish movies about bad mothers? That would have been good.
Spanish-speaking people love their mothers.
El Madre Malo.
Spanish movies for Cinco de Mayo?
El Madre Mas Malo.
Spanish language.
I thought it was a Mexican holiday.
Yeah, but I felt like if I said Mexican movies, it felt Mexican. Like...
Yeah.
It just felt wrong saying it, like Mexican movies. So
oh, man, mom and dad.
Movies to make it more vague.
It's
Spanish. No, you said Spanish.
You just said
movies.
Spanish.
Yeah.
Spanish the language, sorry.
Spanish the language.
I thought that was blood.
Spain and Spain.
There are Mexican movies. Yeah.
Also,
true,
like,
I'm sure. You know, but like, you know.
Yeah, like, you know.
There was one week where we had a theme that was so narrow that it's like
Mexican
the same
movies.
5 movies.
No, like Guillermo del Toro is a Mexican movie maker. Like people who are Mexican and make movies, they make, you know, if they make them in Mexico, that's a Mexican movie, you know?
Also, like, that's you know, true. I think a lot of Mexican people have some problems with the Spanish and what they did. So
yeah.
There's that.
Well, Cinco de Mayo, isn't that about
but
France?
It is the name of the language, and so I understand what Nate was getting at, you know?
Absolutely.
Yeah. I have another movie.
Did you guys watch the Mom and Dad trailer? I just see what? Mom and Dad.
No.
Oh my God!
You know, Timmy, if you wanna, if you see something, you can see in column G. If you put a P there, it'll highlight it in orange, so we'll know to watch it.
Okay.
A little behind the curtain there for you guys.
If it's red, it means it's been submitted more than once, right?
Yeah, but that's fine. We just figure out who submitted it first, and they get the points.
Okay. I just made
okay,
it.
Okay, everyone. All right.
I'm ready. Are you ready?
What are we
That's
watching?
Fucking dope.
Go for it.
Stinger Wipe. Jiggle bro, because we're all school teachers.
We're going to be married.
Oh, no.
What?
Denise will be your new mother.
Surprise.
Todd has a problem.
He thinks his mom's too hot. Is a monster. She growls and she eats bones and she chases joggers.
She's probably a dog.
She's a Trepopkins.
What are Trepopkins?
Did I mention that she eats people?
Coincidence? I think not.
We both know that monsters are merely a figment of the imagination.
Ooh. Oh, that lady.
No, Todd's got to stop her before she gets hungry again.
How do you kill a vampire?
Steaks are the heart.
Oh, how awful.
It's the dad from Punky Brewster.
Cool. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. How about...
That's Corey Feldman from Corey Feldman.
I think specifically it's Corey Feldman from Lost Boys.
Yeah, it looks like the same fucking character.
And the other guy's Alan Thicke, right?
Yeah, oh yeah. Video and the mom is somebody Alan too. I forget her name. Oh, I'm sure we'll find out.
Robin Riker.
Oh, never mind.
I'm all ears.
George Gaines.
Step into the pitch.
John Astin.
Henry Warner.
John Astin.
Oh, and Corey Feldman. Oh, he's awesome.
He is awesome.
Step monster. She's mean. She's green. She's your new mom.
Welcome home, sweetie. Time to trim the hedges.
Fuck yeah.
Roger Corman.
Roger Corman. Oh, Fred cool. Olin Ray. That I give that a point immediately.
I think that was a lot of fun. Yeah.
Yeah. I want to watch that movie like right now. Yeah. Bye.
I also like that the woman from Ferris Bueller was like, monsters are, you know, it's not like ghosts.
Yeah.
Right. It's like, we don't talk about ghosts the same way we talk about monsters. People aren't like, it's a monster. Monsters aren't real. Kids always talking about how they think they saw a monster, you know?
Yeah, that doesn't happen.
Yeah.
I'm not going to give it a point. Just, it didn't do anything for me.
Yeah. What's it feel like to be
dead? Yeah, I'm not either. I was like, why?
That movie's great. I'm a yes.
I'm a yes. Yeah.
So that's,
did you put up the poll, Nate?
Yeah. Yeah. So that's three so far. Ooh. And the poll is overwhelmingly giving it a point, or the poll, the chat. Who submitted that, Sam?
Is that Step Monster? Hendo Calrissian.
Hendo, recent add to the board. He's been on here a couple times. You know what? I think I made the poll too long. So I'm going to assume that's a point. So that's one from Emily, one from Sam, one from Timmy, and one from chat. That's 4 points. We're laying it on thick.
Alan Thick.
Oh, there we are. Principal Role says,
I mean,
wow.
Honestly, as soon as I saw Alan Thicke in, that's all I needed.
Do you know Alan Thicke is Robin Thicke's mom?
Yep.
Robin Thicke's mom?
Yep.
Yep. On theme.
That's on theme, what? Yeah.
On theme.
You guys ready for the next trailer?
Yeah.
No?
Yeah.
Yep.
All right.
No.
Here we go.
Hey, can I go to a movie with Riley tonight?
Yes, right.
Your grandparents are coming for dinner tonight, remember?
Awesome. Grandpa telling us disgusting Vietnam stories.
Take my advice, don't ever have kids.
Everything just revolves around you, doesn't it?
Yeah, whatever.
Yeah, there's definitely going to be an echo. I think some it's speakers me. On loud. It's okay.
What's the rush today? It's like you're waiting for a buffet.
What's going on?
What the fuck? I don't even know any. Is that I've never seen.
Take you out.
Multiple reports are now coming in of parents murdering their own children.
What?
We have to get out of the house before Mom and Dad come home. Dad?
Your right foot in. You take your right foot out. You do the hook in. You.
Cheddar Goblin, you saw this movie?
Whoa.
Yes. Mommy, mommy's here. Are you two all right?
We're not coming out, okay? You have to leave.
You're going to open the door. This is a really great idea, honey.
I forgot your parents.
That was tonight.
Oh, their parents.
Oh, don't show it.
Grandparents gonna kill them.
Ooh,
I like the title card though. Just called Mom and
when,
Dad.
When they say, "Oh, I forgot your dad's coming over," that's an amazing cameo that I won't give away. But
you could spoil it. This isn't spoiler, boys.
I know, but I'm just saying, I feel like people might want to watch that movie because I think that's a really good trailer. It doesn't tell you too much, you know?
Here's the
no,
thing.
No, it doesn't.
If,
that's kind of sick.
If chat gives it a one, oh, wait, I don't know. Let's see.
That well,
you
got to
tell
what?
Us who it is.
The deal with the trailer is it's a teaser to get you to go see the movie. And that kind
of... All right.
Because you're like, I don't get it. Why did that happen?
All right, this is going to be a 1 minute voting time this time, chat. So get your votes in now. Here's the thing. I think it's a fun trailer. It's like, you know, it's like a horror, whatever, thriller, tongue in cheek. Nicolas Cage gets to go like ape shit.
Yeah.
Easy. 1 point. I'd watch it.
Right. I come from the benefit is like, I know that the movie's good. It's directed by one of the Crank guys, you know, like it's ooh. Like it's good, but also I think it's a fun trailer. You just see a bunch of crazy shit, and you're, I mean, that trailer's why I watched it, you know, back however many years ago, you know. So
yeah, not that many years ago.
Either. I'll give it a point. Well, yeah, it's like 2 or 3 years old. I don't know, maybe a little older.
2018, it says.
Oh, okay.
I thought it was no. It was no Step Monster.
Who submitted it, Sam?
Who submitted it?
Oh, I guess a bunch of people submitted it. Yeah.
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 I'm trying to find who submitted it first.
I'll give it a point.
Avalanche Fan 84.
Fan on the board again.
It's item 510, Nate. Item 510.
Oh, got it. Thanks, bud. So that's a point from me, a point from Timmy, a point from chat. That's 3. Sam, that's 0. Emily. Kathy gives it a point?
I don't think she saw it.
Okay. That's 4 points, though. Boom.
Since chat gave it a point, am
did
I supposed
to? Am I frozen, or did you count my point also?
We just did, I think.
Oh, okay. All right, just want to make sure I didn't hear that.
Do you guys want me to tell you who the cameo is now?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah. I know.
You know?
I looked it up.
Okay, so, you know, earlier in the film, it says in the trailer, it's like, oh, yeah, your grandparents come for dinner. And then later, all the parents everywhere are going crazy trying to murder their own children. And then the doorbell rings after they're like trying to get their kids out of the basement at this point. And the doorbell rings and Selma Blair's like, oh, I forgot your dad's coming for dinner. So Nick Cage goes and opens the door, and Lance Henriksen is there with a knife and just immediately starts trying to attack him. It's nice. So fucking awesome.
Lance Henriksen from the Aliens.
Yeah, dude, like Millennium. Like, yeah, all that shit. Yeah.
Yo, I want to go back and watch Millennium because I feel I was too young to get it.
Yeah.
It was like X-Files for only more about aging, right?
It was different than the Millennium movie, which I also liked.
Millennium. Yeah.
Was it the Millennium movie like a bunch of people got time traveled right before they died in a huge plane crash? And in the future, everyone chain smokes or something?
What? Weird. That sounds crazy.
You ready for the next one?
I think so. Emily, do you want me to wait?
Vamp.
She's just feeding the dog. I did the opposite of that.
Emptied the dog.
I emptied the dog. Now she's filling the dog.
That's how it goes.
Did anybody suggest Goonies? Because she's a bad mom.
We watched the Throw Mama from the Train trailer, which was an excellent trailer. Like, as far as trailers go, they just played one scene that perfectly described what was going on in the movie, and then ended it with a shot of the mom having her head hung out of a train.
I remember that from... I've never seen the movie, but I remember that seeing that trailer. Mm-hmm. Back in the day.
All right. You guys ready?
Yeah. I'm a little somnolent. I ate a lot of black licorice tonight.
I'm excited for this.
Long ago, in a wonderful castle, a beautiful princess was born. When the princess was finally grown,
the royal
couple gave their daughter a very special gift, her first kiss. God gave this gift to you because he loves you so dearly. But use wisdom, my daughter, warned the king, and save your kiss for the man you will marry. She's crying.
This is so sweet. I am saving my next kiss, but it makes me so sad that I don't have my very first kiss to give. It's already given.
Yeah. And you can't get it back.
My heart has been asking for a long time, where is my husband, even since I was probably a young teenager. I want the roles the way God designed them because I trust God that he knows a little bit more about this.
Are you guys watching something? Because I don't see anything.
Oh, yeah, it's about God.
Well,
oh, you are watching something? Jeez.
Yeah, I think, right?
Is why a young lady that's mature enough to decide to live away from home by herself is not mature enough to decide who she wants to date.
That's the swan. That's Cygnus the swan right there. That's the swan. That's Cygnus the swan right there.
See, when I get underneath the stars like this, it's like, this can't be an accident. Kelly said, I have been praying for several years for spiritual parents, and I was wondering if you and Don would be the spiritual parents for my courtship.
If I do meet someone that I think would be a good mate, I would ask him then to meet with Ron. Over the years, Ron has met with different people, but there has never been one who I've been interested in who has also been interested in me.
So you've never dated, you have no girlfriend.
My God, he looks like a fucking serial killer.
You've been saving your first kiss.
Mm. You really believe that God is in control?
I really do.
Why? We have free will. Don't wait for him to bring somebody to your door.
Why?
It's not going to happen.
We totally believe that God will turn the world upside down to put two people together that he wants together. That's what Kelly is doing. She's staking the rest of her life on, is God going to come through on this?
Tick-tock, tick-tock. The biological clock.
Honey, you got to get fucking.
Was that a documentary?
Yeah.
I made a huge mistake. My godparents need to approve first.
Yeah, not your actual godparents, but your parents picked by God.
Picked by God. Which is Kathy. God picked her as my godmom, so now she gets to decide.
Church mom, I kissed my hand, church mom. What do I do?
A courtship?
I give it zero.
I give it a point.
I give it a point because I want to see it so bad.
I didn't come here to talk about God.
Timmy, Sam's lane right now is religious movies.
I think they're so funny and so fascinating, really, and the trailers for them are so fun to watch.
Sam, if you ever want to see those, you know, when they play here, they stay for a while. Really? My theater also played, you know, a couple years ago, Dinesh D'Souza, that fucking Trump simp, you know, he's always making basically fucking propaganda for Trump. And they played one of those movies here, and it was like, you know, just a bunch of fucking like crazy conspiracy theories, you know. But anyways, it didn't look that fun to me. I don't know.
Kathy, with us?
I just didn't like it. It was a documentary.
Turn your phone camera on. Turn your phone on.
It is on.
Look at the camera part, though.
I am.
Can you see us?
Yeah.
All right. Turn the video off, hit the video button, and then hit it again. Oh. Nope.
Yep. Try to get her in a widescreen?
I don't know. We don't see her.
So that guy that she meets in that trailer, he kills her, right?
He kills her.
I think so. Yeah.
I think with the parents. Yeah.
They
track down a guy who's willing to sacrifice her to God with them.
Yeah. It's this whole Abraham thing.
It's gonna be
God
good.
Doesn't step in.
That was my favorite part of the Noah movie when it turned into like a slasher movie at the end.
I just love like giving up your first kiss. I wish I'd waited till marriage. That's wild.
Yeah.
Wild. She's crying. It's great.
You got to practice. You got to have those hot lips when you meet the right person. You got to have hot kisses ready. You got to know about your gyrations. You got to have that shit prepared.
Well, what year was this? Is it like a Duggar movie?
It seems very Duggery. I think
it's very Duggery. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah,
but what's not a good point is the zero I'm giving this trailer.
I'm giving it a zero too.
Okay, this next trailer.
Hold on. What did you guys give it? Who gave it points?
I gave it a point. We already gave it a point.
And chat. Yeah, I missed chat. I missed what chat gave it.
It's a gotta see it.
Nate, can you see me?
Yeah, I got you, Mom.
Oh. Okay.
What number was that one, Sam? A courtship, 540. That's 2 points. Wait, chat, I'm going to assume you gave it zero because I feel like we're clicking tonight. Okay.
That's not right. Fair.
No one ever marked Serial Mom yet, so I'll mark that one because so many people submitted it.
Yeah, so actually, let me talk to chat. Let's just do Serial Mom right now. Serial Mom was the first movie submitted, and it got submitted
and a
whopping 38 times.
Wow.
Yeah, everyone is into Serial Mom. But guess who submitted it first?
Zombie Bender! I was looking at it.
I thought you guessed. Anyway, so let's watch that one.
I saw this movie on a debate trip, on HBO, on a debate trip, when I was in high school.
Oh wait, am I bringing it up?
Who's bringing it up?
You were, sorry, buddy.
Oh, I thought you were bringing it up. Sorry,
I was too busy doing the stingers. Womp. You guys like that? How cool that is!
Oh, there it goes.
Oh, I'm not seeing it. It's not playing for me.
There it is.
Sorry, got it.
Oh, I love this movie.
This is the story of Beverly Sutphen.
It's quiet.
It's a John Waters.
Sorry, yeah, John Waters. It's too quiet.
I'm so happy I could chip. You know how I hate the brown word.
A loving wife.
You think the kids are awake?
We could be very quiet.
I'm ready.
Honey, you're hot tonight.
And a suspected murderer.
Oh, kids, are you doing your homework?
How did America's number one mom turn into one of America's most wanted? Is she really guilty?
Are you a serial killer?
Chip, the only cereal I know anything about is Rice Krispies.
Is she the only one with a motive?
Believe that damn litter butter.
Give her a happy face.
Or is there someone else?
I'm stood up. I'll kill that jerk.
With an axe to grind.
That scene rules.
Let's get a boyfriend.
Meanwhile, this small Baltimore suburb Please! Keeps getting smaller and smaller.
It's been a crazy day, hasn't it?
Savoy Pictures asks the burning question,
is your wife mental?
Is Beverly Sutphen just a sweet suburban housewife?
I don't know what it is about today, but I feel great. Cookie?
Or is she serial mom?
Cool. Is she in a band?
Kathleen Turner, Sam Waterston, and Ricky Lake. Serial mom. Every woman wants to be wanted. Just not for murder one.
Beverly, I've read all about this. Is it menopause?
Bad of the ball. Bad of the ball.
Paul Wonder from WBRI Radio says, damn.
I loved the review. Move over, Mrs. Doubtfire.
Yeah.
We're all just like, honestly, same movie.
Yeah. We're itching to get rid of Mrs. Really. Doubtfire.
94. 94 what? Oh, 1994.
1994.
I will say that I love that movie, and the trailer gives it. The trailer brings it.
Yeah,
it does.
Suzanne Summers is in it, Toph.
That scene really? In the that scene in the urinal. What ends up happening there is great.
I don't remember.
Sparky said, "That's dark."
I don't remember having
that's dark. Why was there a secret store in the Blockbuster? Yeah. Interesting.
Porn room, man. Probably the porn room, right?
Yeah, it's the porn room.
Dude, there was a porn shop we shot a sketch in for the show that even had a porn room. Remember, Sam? It's like
sub porn room. That was that's bad.
Below my apartment.
That was below your apartment.
That was there was a
porn Sam lived over a den of sin.
Yeah.
We used to buy bootleg movies from there for like $3 a movie.
Oh, sure, yeah.
bootleg this was regular before movies, Cecil B. Demented.
Yeah, bootleg regular movies, yes. Cool.
Chuck gives like that a point, and I obviously give that a point.
6 years.
I'm giving it a point.
It's three.
It's a lot of fun. It has Bad to the Bone in it.
That fucking sealed it for me.
And yeah. It's like kind of, it might be ironic, but it's also just fun to put in there, you know?
Yeah. She kind of is, you know, she really epitomizes that June Cleaver look.
Yeah,
totally. You know, pearls and everything. I'll give it a one.
You know, they didn't announce Matthew Lillard in the cast, though. Is he not famous yet?
I don't think people knew who he was.
This was pre-screen.
Tell you what, that
I mean, this was 94 again? Like, he wasn't famous. We didn't know his name for another 5 years.
Yeah, when did Scream come out?
99? Was it really 99?
Is it 98?
I want to say it's 96, actually. Late.
Oh, what?
Okay. 96, you
know,
yeah.
I honestly thought that would be like a really problematic trailer. I thought there'd be like some problematic stuff in that trailer, but there wasn't. So
odd. Well, I think that one was in like real theaters and stuff, you know. It was the 90s by that point. You couldn't have Divine eating dog shit in your trailer anymore.
Yeah. You know? Oh, there were no trailers. For that.
Chat's saying that you were yawning through that whole one, and so they think you were bored by it, Kathy.
Me? Oh, yeah. I'm just tired. I've been up since 6. So.
Yeah, dude, it's almost midnight her time and your time.
She's a night person. Yeah. Sam and Emily are waiting for your points.
Yeah.
I'm going to pass. It was a little long for me.
I'll go sure. Give it a point.
Okay. 5 points for Zombie B.
I'm probably going to go soon, by the way. I'm losing energy. I got a lot to do tomorrow.
Wow.
Cool.
I know. What else? There's some good suggestions in here. Jeez.
Load them up. This I mean, one. You guys can go back and forth if you got one, Timmy.
I've got one loaded up.
Okay. Do it, Sammy.
And then, Timmy, you can pick the next one.
Okay.
Oh, wait. Mother's wrong Day one. Company, wrong one.
1980, huh?
You guys already watched
wrong this? Wrong one. Oh. I wanted to do the other one.
I think they just showed this Mother's Day on Joe Bob.
Oh, yeah. He was in Hackers. Hackers came out in 95. Was that his big break, Hackers?
Or I guess I thought it was SLC Punk, but I guess Scream was
SLC big Punk break. Came out way later, right? I love that movie.
Oh, maybe it did.
Birthday cake in 10 minutes, guys.
Did they remake it?
You left the door unlocked?
Is that maybe. Punisher? No, what is his name?
It's
Frank Grillo.
Frank Grillo, who should play Punisher.
What are you guys doing in my house?
He played Crossbones.
There's a cool jump up on the table.
State authorities have just released the identities of the suspects.
That's a terrible sketch.
Wanted for rape and murder. The bank robberies.
Johnny's been hurt.
Oh my God!
We're at the house. Just get Mother and get here fast.
What are we gonna do about this?
Samara, I gotta fix this.
Did he get shot yourself. In the leg?
Mama's coming. She's not gonna be happy. Hello, Mother.
Please, get up. Make yourselves comfortable. I'm so sorry, I don't want you lying there on the floor.
Go sit down on the sofas.
Now, you fail to cooperate with anything, there will be consequences. You see, rules are what make order out of chaos. We must follow rules.
Yeah, there's gonna be echo. My mom doesn't know. Thank guys, it's okay.
That was probably my fault, man.
She always is impulsive.
Never received any money.
Please, I believe you. You, I'm not so sure about.
Yeah.
Where's the money? They're monsters.
Remember the rules, dear.
We just gotta sit here and let them take us one by one, huh?
Mommy! Mommy! Rebecca didn't have that.
Mother is gonna be very unhappy.
You taught them to be killers! I taught them to survive. I swear, sometimes you boys are just little savages.
Wow, it doesn't even look like her.
So,
here's my problem. Am I supposed to buy that Frank Grillo is ever going to be a victim ever?
Yeah, but I was Frank like, Grillo, oh, he's going to be a bad guy?
Those motherfuckers' wrists. Anyways.
He was a victim to those wolves in that one movie.
That's right. Spoiler. Yo, have you seen the movie where he fights aliens with the guys from the raid? Skyline 2? Good.
No.
Oh, dude, you don't even need to use Skyline. Skyline 1 is almost unrelated. But Skyline 2, Frank Grillo has a son and who gets taken. And so he and two Indonesian dudes run around with knives and like kill a bunch of aliens. Anyways, have that you movie seen, looked all right. What?
Have you seen the movie where Frank Grillo trains Joel Egerton to beat up Tom Hardy?
No, I haven't.
Oh, that movie is the fucking is Warrior, best, dude.
Yeah, Warrior. Fucking
rules. Dude, I didn't know Frank Grillo was in it.
Frank Grillo. While Nick Nolte trains Tom Hardy to beat up Joel Egerton.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that movie's rad. So, funny story about that movie, and this is part of the reason why I picked it, is Trevor is friends with this the guy who directed Fanboys, Kyle Newman, who was married to Jamie King. And I hung out at his house once, and there was this guy, Darren, there. And the guy is Darren Lynn Boosman, who directed that movie. And they were working on it, and they told me about it, and I was like, oh, that's similar to this movie I saw, Lady in a Cage. And he was like, oh my, that's the movie I'm basing this after. Like, that was like a big inspiration of his. He like freaked out, but
don't tell anybody.
It was interesting to hear him talk about this movie and then see this trailer, because I hadn't seen it before.
He also directed a number of the Saw films, and I think he directed the new one that's coming out.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Wait, did Chris Rock like write that or produce that?
Yeah, so as far as I know, I read about it a while back, and I guess Chris Rock like loves the Saw movies, and he's like, I got an idea, I want to make one. They were like, all right. You know?
Yeah.
And it's like him, and I think Samuel L. Jackson is in it too, and I'm gonna see it because I watched all those.
Yeah.
That was one of my favorite drunk conversations between you and I in a taxi once. Do you remember this?
Saw movies?
We were talking about the Saw movies once, and I was like, I don't think I've seen any of those of you. And you were like, no. And like, one of us said, like, we should watch them all one time because there's seven of them, so they must be good. I don't know which one of us said that. It was like, you know, coming home from piano at like 4 a.m.
I think the more accurate statement is there's seven of them, so they must be movies.
Well, let's hit the points for that. Chad gave that zero.
Nate gave that a zero. I kind of enjoyed it as a trailer, but I think it did give away. It gave away pretty much the whole plot.
I do want to see it. It was too long.
The one thing that I was wanting to see that I didn't get was like the police show up at the door and Rebecca De Mornay is like, hello, officers, how can I help you? And they're like, everything's cool here. She's just a nice mom. You know, like, you know, that scene exists in the movie, right? That has to. And I wanted to see it and I didn't get to see it. So I am giving it 0 points. Chat's with me. Timmy is on the bubble. Timmy's a zero.
I'll do zero.
Kathy B.
I'm going to give it a zero because I don't, they gave so much of it away.
Yeah.
Like the idea that mom is creepy crazy is thrown out there right in the beginning. You know, they could kind of hid that for a little bit.
Also, I don't want to shit on Rebecca De Mornay's career because I know she's had a big long one, but the way they tease that mom reveal, you expected someone who you would instantly recognize, no matter who you are.
Yeah, you really did not recognize.
And I didn't. You know.
Yeah.
I mean, I was expecting, like, you know, fucking, like, you know, the lady.
Wonder Twins? What are you giving that one?
Didn't Rebecca De Mornay date Harry Dean Stanton?
Oh.
Really?
Like, I think, like, during Risky Business.
What was the age Harry gap? Dean.
During Risky Business?
Wow. Yeah.
Wow.
I think it's something like that.
Well, she wasn't going to date Tom Cruise, that's for sure.
26.
Timmy, do you want to pick the next one? And then Sam and Emily, what are you guys giving that?
Okay, so
zero.
He was 33 years older than her, but hey, okay. Anyway.
Whoa.
I don't see.
Wait, let me see if this is true. Maybe I'm making this up. Oh, wait, it comes up.
Clown Baby. Winner of previous episodes submitted that one.
Yeah, they dated.
Well, I don't know. Whatever. How old is he now, or is he still with us?
Harry Dean Stanton, he died in 2017 or so. He died right after he shot Twin Peaks Season 3.
Oh.
He was like freaking like 94. He was like 89 or 90, 91 when he shot that Twin Peaks stuff. It's like,
Jesus.
Cletus Van Dam says, let's do movies starring wrestlers next week. But the only problem with that is we already watched Money Plane. So we've already seen the winner, you know?
With true. Yeah.
I don't know. There's some Hulk Hogan films and there's some like Triple H films. And there's the See No Evils. I mean, there's some contenders out there.
Money Plan is amazing.
I mean, fucking They Live, you know? Like,
you know, John Moxley's in movies.
Oh.
He's in the like 12th round sequel, like the sequels to movies that originally starred John Cena.
I'd be a clever little hipster and submit Barton Fink.
I don't get the reference.
It's about writing wrestling movies. I'm gonna pick out.
Right, well, so you wouldn't. It would be off theme.
It would be off theme because there's not wrestlers in it.
Yeah.
Okay, you're right. What about what?
I'm just giving you a hard time.
No, I get it. No, it's all good. I was trying to read at the same time. Okay, I just see Flanja, if that's how you say that, submitted this one, Flesh-Eating Mothers. So that sounds great for me to go out on. So
you gave it away.
That's the name of the movie.
I know, but we experience it like you watch it in the movie theater.
You don't know what it is.
And then you're like, Flesh-Eating Mothers, of course.
You announced cereal, Mom. Solid
values. It was ubiquitous. Go to
school. Is it working?
The fathers have
good jobs.
That's it.
Anybody home?
Yeah.
So quiet. And the mothers eat their
children. This kind of reminds me of that.
I already know my answer.
Eating mothers.
My mother ate my baby brother.
My mother ate my father.
Never done anything like this before.
See what happens when a strange virus is covered up by the authorities.
It's an epidemic out there. The mothers are eating their children.
That's a delivery right there. And sends the
housewives into whoa.
That's pretty freaky.
In my mind.
Yeah, that's weird.
Don't talk about my mother that way.
You'd think in the future they would show some good breeding.
Oh, mother!
I'm taking a slow budget.
I believe the term is no budget.
Yeah. Except that mouth. Mother with the big mouth. That was pretty good.
Yeah, that mouth is pretty cool.
The kids is preparing them for dinner.
And take matters. What was this production company called?
Probably Flesh Eating Mothers Inc. That's how it always works with these.
Well, my mother told me never to deck a lady, but she didn't say shit about a cannibal.
Oh, yes!
Flesh-eating mothers bit off more than they could chew.
I love like the bad animation too. Fuck.
Yeah.
Funny that they showed the title like three times.
Yeah, that's like old school. Like
five times.
Wow, everyone, wow.
That was fantastic.
Let me give a poll out for chat while you vamp it out for that one.
I mean, that was fantastic. I mean, I definitely. I'm like, I'm gonna look that up on Just Watch right now to see if it's streaming on anything. But yeah. Wow. I mean, that trailer had everything. And maybe, I would say there's a likelihood, given that it's low budget, no budget, they probably gave away all the money shots. But, ladies and gentlemen, it is streaming on Amazon Prime.
Whoa.
Watch party? Can you do a watch party? You have to pay for it.
No.
No, it's on Prime Video.
Oh, damn.
Yeah, we could do a watch party.
Here's the thing about that, like I feel like I'm definitely giving that a point, no brainer.
Yeah.
But I don't understand how a movie like Dawn of the Dead could be so lauded and a movie like Flesh Eating Mothers is like unknown. I've never even heard of it before.
Well, I mean, I think it's in the production value. I mean, George Romero has a control of tone and knew how to direct a scene and put a lot of subtext in, and I don't know if you can tell if any of that's in Flesh Eating Mothers, you know?
Well, the trailer delivered.
That's true, but it also is super silly. I mean, the pop, the blood squirting out of the bullet hole. You know? we loved it, but I don't think we loved it for the same reasons we loved the original Dawn of the Dead. You know?
I agree, Mom.
Is a robot eating your mom?
No, we're just going to pretend it didn't happen.
Mommy,
my mom's having an electronic stroke right now.
Did I not come through?
It was cut out on that.
Obviously, let me just say that was a Panwall submission. Panwall never misses. Okay,
Right.
People talk about Newsboys never missing. Panwall, actually, no. I think Panwall submitted a titty in one, and we had to give him a minus point for that. Panwall usually never misses. Always got some good stuff there. I think that might have been the best one you submitted. I don't know. Like, chat gave that a 91% point. So, like, yeah, chat was feeling that.
Yeah.
I'm feeling it. Timmy?
One. Unless I'm going to leave, maybe let me give it 7.
Miss Candini?
I love Panwall, but that's no points for me. Huh? I feel like I've seen that trailer 20 times in this show. I can't get points for that anymore. They got to punch it up a bit. These low budge, they got to have a little something extra, some more spice. Yeah.
I would say that the effects, the makeup and effects were special.
They almost got me on the bullet through the head, because people, when they die, their eyes cross traditionally. But I just, like, I've seen better, like, horror movies trailers.
The huge mouth stuff was so cool, though.
Yeah.
The biting through the chain.
Special, like, those effects are special. Like, not special effects, but, like,
I love you, Panwall. I'm so sorry. I've given you so many points.
What are you feeling?
I give it a point. I thought that it looked like a fucking Attack on Titan.
I don't know what that is, but I'm into it. KB.
You know what I started thinking was, Black Hole Sun, won't you come?
Oh, yeah.
Didn't win points with the females in the panel, but Chat gave it a point.
You said the females. Oh, I give Nate 0 points.
You can say females.
I'm friendly call. Everyone first uses females, and it always makes me feel weird. Like he's gonna keep them in a fridge somewhere, you know. Anyway, I'm gonna go.
Timmy, thanks so much for coming on.
Hey, thanks, Kathy. It was great to see you.
I see you, Timmy, too.
All right, boys, girls, have fun. How many more are you gonna do?
I don't know. 1,000.
Cool. Well, I gotta go to bed.
Bye. I got one that I definitely wanted to see. Good to see you, Timmy.
You too, buddy. See you guys later.
Bye, Timmy. All
right, hitting the button.
Today, I gotta do the whole screen because we're only down to like three people now. Hold on, sorry. What?
I was team captain at Westfield.
Start it again.
Ready?
Yes.
Student today, please welcome Cameron Lowe to Raleigh High. I was team captain at Westfield, Mom. Do you know how hard I had to work to get that?
Raleigh has won state 4 years in a row. With you on the team, they might as well call it 5. You're not sitting here.
Ooh. All right, one-on-one drills. Cameron, Haley, try and get past her. Nice work, Cameron.
Your mom is a super coach. She wins every year and with different players.
Yeah, imagine if she can't win with her own kid on the team.
You're the star now. You're the star.
I can tell soccer means a lot to you.
I love the music.
We're very lucky to have you on the team.
Yeah.
Your grades drop, you are suspended from the team.
I just finished marking your test. You failed.
Cameron tells me you took her off the starting and replaced her with your own daughter. Seems a little too convenient.
No idea who you're dealing with.
My responsibility is to my team. It's my team, my rules.
Ooh. That's it?
What was it called?
Wait, the thing's called it Lethal Soccer Moms, but I think the trailer called it Parental Misconduct.
I hope it has two different titles.
I think it's funny that, like, it spoke too soon. They got Kamala Harris as the principal. That's funny.
Oh, hold on. Fuck some shit up. Okay. That was called Lethal Soccer Moms?
Yeah.
Lethal Soccer Moms.
I guess we go back to giving chat 2 points. No, Timmy's not here.
Yeah, okay. Okay, I'm not going to give that one a point. I was let down. Lethal Soccer Moms sounded awesome. It was a zombie bender. Zombie bender gets a lot of points. And I want to show another zombie bender one. I don't think I can. If I'm going to show another zombie bender one, I'm not going to give that one a point.
Okay.
I kind of didn't get in, you know, it was kind of fast and I lost track of who was who. They all pretty much had the same hair color. And they were all either coaches or playing soccer. So I didn't know who was who. So I didn't know what was going on. So it didn't give me what I needed to know to get me to see the movie. So I'll say zero. Sorry.
That's another zero. So did that get any points?
No. Here, I'm going to give Zombie Bender a chance at redemption. They seemed more into this one.
Okay, how many pancakes you want?
Six.
Ten. Okay, how many pancakes you want?
Six. Ten.
Ten pancakes.
Ten. Say two.
Oh, what do you guys want to do this afternoon?
The park.
The zoo.
I was told my wife's here, Kayleen Larson.
So, officially, I'm Vanessa. I'm one of your nurses. Hi.
Hi, Auntie Samantha.
Hi, guys.
Come here.
How many pills are you taking?
This is too much medication for an entire platoon.
She looks familiar, but I don't know who she is.
How much do you know about this woman?
Who the hell are you?
Mr. Larson, Detective Dawkins, can we talk?
I think she believes your children are her children. She's your egg donor.
Uh-oh.
I am your real mommy.
It's sink or swim kind.
Where are the kids?
She took them. Just go find them. Go!
Where are you going?
Come on. Oh, I give that a one.
I like that better than the last one, ZB.
Oh, yeah. Me too.
Yeah. Do you see that cop get a Charlie horse?
No.
Back or was it a bullet?
Oh. No, it's a bullet, but it looks like he like hits his knee on the car.
Oh, okay.
Go to 142.
Oh,
I right. I knocked my knee. Ooh. Oh,
trick knee. Wrestling injury from high school. God damn it.
Put the car there.
That was called the wrong mother.
Yeah. Similar plot. Yeah, the wrong mother. Will Ferrell, Kristen Wiig, Lifetime movie? Huh.
That one? No.
All right, chat. There you go. You know what? I thought that was ridiculous. I thought it was ridiculous, and I'm going to give it a point for ridiculousness.
I'm a zero. Sorry, guys. I'm sorry, guys. It's an anti-egg donor movie. There's no way I'm supporting that.
True. Wow. Oh. Didn't think about it like that, guys.
The idea that woman, you know, in that little thing, you're like, man, so she snuck into a hospital, dressed up like her nurse, took care of the woman in the hospital.
Wait, I thought she was an actual nurse. She wasn't an actual nurse ever?
No. Well, no. Yeah. They went back in and they said, yeah, we don't know who she is.
Oh, yep. Wow.
Kathy, yeah. I have a question. Could a nurse, could a person get away with that in a hospital?
Never. Never in a million years.
Zero time.
See, I feel like they could, because if you show up and you know what you're doing and you're like, pretend like you're doing, people are going to be like, fuck it, less work for me to do.
No, because no, it's just
you're like, hey, I'm here to wipe that person's asshole. They're like, look at somebody good. No, that person's a good nurse. We're glad to have you on the team.
Kathy, do all nurses have a secret handshake so you all know each other's for real?
Yeah, it's this.
Very sick.
No, you just wouldn't. I mean, there's too many locked drawers and closets. And if actually, if you see somebody like that on my unit, you call security right away, because first thing you think of is they're going to steal a baby, or that's the goal. So on kind of a different unit. But even when I was on a med surg unit, if somebody was walking around in a nurse's uniform and nobody knew who she was, well, she's crazy. And we've had those people too. So, you know,
I mean, do you all just jump on her? That's not a nurse. She doesn't know the handshake. And you all jump on her at the same time.
Somebody follows her until security gets there. We let those morons take over.
I missed the chat. I've missed what you gave that for points, guys.
I gave it a 1.
Kathy, go 1. Sam, Emily?
0.
Wait, you asked chat. Someone said 2. Next person said 0. Next person said 1.
Yeah.
It got a 0 in the poll, is what people are saying.
Okay.
I'll give it a 1.
I'll give it a 1. That's 3?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Will you find that and put the points down for that? Because I got a trailer. I haven't picked a trailer all night.
All right.
I want to see it.
And then I might crash. It's after midnight.
Oh, we're wrapping it up, Mom. You got to stay on to the end.
Oh, all right. I have to load every one of these separately.
Hello, girls. Caitlin, come help me in the kitchen. Hurry up, because I forget where it is.
That's her mom. She's got amnesia.
What if you couldn't remember your real name? Your first kiss? Or your last goodbye.
I don't remember.
He said that in the ETA on that in the voiceover.
Stow it.
And then suddenly.
I used to do this. I'm a chef. Yo!
Without warning.
Give me something else.
Celery. Italian.
Cut all the shit up.
All your memories.
Name's Charlie. I'm coming back.
Came flooding back to you.
Evening, Charlie.
Long time.
One bullet at a time.
I got movement on Samantha Kane.
Good.
I may have a lead on someone. They still have some of her stuff.
This man, he's gonna help me find some things out, so we'll be safe.
Your full name is Charlene Elizabeth Baltimore. This could be trouble.
My name is Samantha Kane.
No, forget all that.
I'm in the PTA.
Then quit. You're an assassin working for the United States government.
I'm in the PTA. 24 hours.
Find her. I'm gonna kill her.
Run for your life!
Baltimore's alive, sir.
Who are you?
Name's Charlie. The spy.
Back when we first met, you were all like, oh, fooey, I burned the darn muffins. Now, you go into a bar, 10 minutes later, sailors come running out. What up with that?
What? Honk if there's any trouble.
Yeah, so Miss Daisy, I'd be honking.
If you have plans for a calm, quiet evening.
Cover your ears. Hey, should we get a dog?
It's time to kiss them all. Good night.
I love you.
Gina Davis, Samuel L. Jackson, The Long Kiss Goodnight, directed by Rennie Harlan.
Ooh, Rennie Harlan directed that. I have no idea.
Yeah.
Let me just say, I was feeling that. That's somebody said in chat. Who was it? It wasn't a bad mom. That was a badass mom. And I agree.
Yeah,
that's true.
Very good description.
It's a little off.
We watched that recently.
What?
We've watched that pretty recently.
Yeah, that movie's good.
The movie's good.
Same. That movie's great. Any Gina Davis trailer, I'm giving points to. So
it's you know what? That's a good Gina team.
Do you guys know Gina Davis is from Wareham?
I did not.
Ooh, I did not.
Wareham, Massachusetts.
I think that's a great trailer. Aside from it being, it's a cool movie. I think that's a great trailer. I think that's like with Throw Mama from the Train, one of the more like interestingly designed trailers we've seen tonight. The way it kind of does the switch-o change-o, you think it's a movie about amnesia, and it's an action movie about amnesia. I like the way they present that scene, the carrots, the chopping scene where she throws it. I think that's a really cool scene.
Not the carrots. And
I think I also really like, that's funny that Rennie Harlan directed Die Hard 2 and Samuel Jackson was in Die Hard 3. But Samuel Jackson, that line that they have in the movie, when we met, you were all like, "Oh, fooey, I burned the darn muffins." And now when you walk into a bar 10 minutes later, sailors come running out. That's a great line.
Yeah, that's really good.
Yeah,
that line sticks in my head. "Oh, fooey, I burned the darn muffins." I say it all the time. But I think that is an underrated, like very, very criminally underrated action film, you know? And I think it's sexist. I think it's because there's a woman at the head of it. But I also think just now that I'm seeing that, like, Samuel Jackson is like pretty young in that, you know, relatively compared to like what we know him as now. But like in that movie, he plays like an old guy, which I think is really funny. Yeah. Like, you know, he's kind of like a past his prime detective, you know, and he's wearing all these clothes from the 70s and stuff. So I'm like, he's gonna be, you know, like my age when that movie was made. I'm old.
Well, she kind of ends up, you know, she is a badass in that film, almost like what Angelina Jolie wanted to be, you know, like, yeah, I'll do that. And Gina Davis like did it great, like with a sense of humor and sassy and like, I'm gonna get you motherfuckers, you're gonna be out of here. And so I like
the F word.
I also gave a finger
as a point
to describe nurses. I think our secret handshake was the middle finger. Yeah.
Do you give the middle finger like this or like this?
Could be like that. Like, although then my finger looks very big when I do that, so I don't know.
You do it with the thumb out though. You do it with the thumb out? What?
No, my thumb's out because it's kind of broken.
Oh, you're fucked up thumb.
I always just do this.
Yeah, when you give...
Fuck you! Fuck you! Right here! Right here!
All right, so Chat gives it 2 points. I give it a point. Kathy Brown sounds like you give it a point. Emily gave it a point. Sam...
Point.
Wow. Okay.
I like that. That might be my favorite.
Oh, so let me see. I think you have time for one more mom trailer.
One more?
And okay. Then what we'll do is we'll figure out what the trailer of the week nominees are, because I think we actually have like too many, so we may have to whittle it down a bit.
Yeah.
And then we will watch a trailer, a bonus trailer, while we're voting on that. And then we're also going to figure out what the theme for next week is. And I think the winner, if they're on, gets to choose one of the theme options. Or do you just want to pick a theme, Sam? I think we're overcomplicating it. We'll just feel it.
You know what's weird? How come all these mom trailers, a good majority of them were like horror movies or stuff? Wasn't there like funny movies about moms? No?
Well, it was Bad Moms.
Oh, it's Bad Moms. Okay, now I get it. I'm like, okay.
I feel like there's funny movies about bad moms. There's got to be, right?
Yeah, Bad Moms.
Oh my gosh, the hit of the century.
Oh, it was right there. The
All right, you ready?
Okay.
You know that evil heavy metal that your parents hate you listening to?
Metal.
You know those lyrics about hell, demons, and doom? What if I told you it's all real? I know. I was there. I was there.
Jesus! It's piss.
That's me, Brody. My friends are losers, so we started a band.
Check it out.
Ricky Daggers. Is he dead? Wouldn't it be crazy if the music had something to do with demons?
Demons.
We're all gonna die.
I translated those pages. Now, people are turning crazy, like possessed crazy.
What's up?
That was pretty cool, as is, I mean, the accent though.
I'm not even sure I'm in the right tuning.
Brother of Steel. I don't know how that fits
this. Those have to do with mothers, bad or good or yeah. Neutral.
Who submitted that?
This kind
Devin's
of
fits. Brother.
Devin's brother said this kind of fits the top three in the poll, Bad Mothers, High School, and Heavy Metal. Oh, from, and they don't mention in the trailer, but in the movie, the main character's father is long dead and his mother is institutionalized. Bad Mother.
Okay. All right.
Okay, Devin's brother. It's a stretch. It's not in the trailer, so it's tough. We got a bunch of these where it was like when we were doing the drug movies, it was a lot of movies where the drugs were in the movie, but not in the trailer. So it was hard to tell. Okay. Poll going up in a sec. All right. Poll. So, Sam, let's go through the list here because we have five, and I think we have more than five. So keep a mental note, I guess. Serial Mom got five. Mommy Dearest got five. Deranged got six.
Okay.
Remember, Timmy left, so his vote is
yeah,
not...
no, we wrote all the points down. It's not he, okay. His points right. Don't get wiped because he leaves. All right. Okay. Sierra Mom, Mommy Dearest, Deranged, Throw Mama from the Train.
What is it? ZZ?
Oh, ZZ is a placeholder. So like if we want to give somebody points to add it to the thing, that's how we manually put it in.
It looks like it has 4 points.
Yeah. Can you read the thing?
Points for guessing. Oh, okay.
Yeah, see, that was last week. So you'll see, like, you know, if you've given out points randomly to people in chat and they end up like that.
Okay.
Did you give anybody a point today?
No.
Oh, all right.
Any moms in chat?
That was a zero deathgasm. Let me say, yeah.
Neamix gets a point. No. Nope. Niamix does not.
Now everyone's saying they're a mom.
They're moms.
Okay. Going back. We still have a bunch. All right. So here's the problem, guys. Chat gave that a zero. I give it a zero too because it didn't have moms.
Yes, I give it a zero.
Chat, here's the problem. We want to do trailer of the week, but we have too many trailers to choose from. We have, again, let's go through the list to count it. Serial Mom, Mommy Dearest, Deranged. Deranged has to be in there. Throw Mama from the Train, Mom and Dad, Flesh-Eating Mothers, Step Monster, Long Kiss Goodnight. We have eight, so we need to get rid of three. And if we're going by lowest scores, we're going to get rid of Step Monster, Flesh-Eating Mom, Mom and Dad. Nope, I guess we can't do that. There's too many. All right. What are we getting rid of, Sam? Oh, wait, I guess we do have 3, 4.1, so I guess that works.
Yeah, so it'd be...
Sorry, guys. So what would normally be in contention, but because they scored lower on that side, we're moving out Mom and Dad, Step Monster, and unfortunately Flesh-Eating Mothers, Panwall RIP. They're catching up on you, buddy. They're catching up.
Unfortunately, Step Monster...
All right, vamp it up, Sam. Talk about some themes that we're thinking about for next week.
Themes for next week. The wrestling one sounds really fun. I still want to throw Fast Cars in there. I think that'll be a really good theme when eventually someone votes.
I think
for.
Slow cars and trailers is a great thing. Just, you know, those trailers that have someone pull up in a junker.
True. Like Uncle Buck.
Yes, exact. Exact. What about trailers that involve Halloween? Is that too October?
More scary movies. Like,
that it'll be like so many scary movies.
It'll be all scary movies. What about? I mean, there's some movies that are happen around Halloween, but nothing scary happens. What about Home Alones?
Squidward submitted Long Kiss Goodnight, by the way.
Movies with kids that are home alone.
What about
High School?
I like High School as a theme.
Oh, High School is good. High School.
We put that in. So we have, let me see, start poll. All right, so the poll's up for Trailer of the Week, everyone. While we vote, I had a trailer that I wanted everyone to watch.
What about island movies?
Island movies, that's good.
Oh yeah, that's a good one. I have one yeah. For island. Yeah.
Okay.
You have a trailer you're gonna submit?
Yeah.
All right. You guys watching? We're watching a trailer now. Everyone in chat can vote, but okay. We're gonna watch this. This is outside of the theme, so you don't have to put up a stink like this isn't part of the theme. So all right.
Let's see what you think. This is going a little nuts, I think. But
also, it's mono.
School of French Kissing for Dogs, shout out.
What does that mean?
It's one channel.
Oh, okay. Is that Trevor down there?
No, it's a guy that looks like Trevor.
No.
Oh my God.
Roland Emmerich's race war, everyone.
Whoa.
Problematic.
Where'd you find that?
We finally got to use it.
Problematic.
This is the week that Nate and I learned how to use After Effects.
Yeah, your boys are getting tricky with the After Effects. Shout out to the guys that were able to help me figure some stuff out with the cool the head stinger. You see this?
Problematic.
Well, I did both at the same time. Hilarious.
Did you do that yourself?
Well, Sam made the problematic, which goes like this. Oh, did I fuck it up? I did. I hit the button too many times.
Wow.
But I made this. Aren't you proud of us?
I am very proud.
Okay, this is what I made. This stinger where it changes, then all of a sudden we're in a new scene, right? And if you want to see it again, it goes like this. Oh, no, I fucked that up. Sorry. Anyway, this is the one Sam made.
Problematic. Okay,
spinner, so I may have
to. That's cool as shit, right? Oh, no, you can't. You know what? I realize you can't see it because we are not doing that. You're watching the thing and we're doing the thing. All right, so Deranged won. Let me see what the score was here. Oh, Deranged had 33%. Serum Mom in second place at 26%. Not a whole ton of votes. Mommy Dearest on the bottom. Oh. Wow. All right. Deranged, yeah. I fucking loved. So let me see. Deranged. Wow. Kit Black. Boom. Kit Black, congratulations. Is Kit Black still in chat? So I guess, you know.
Congratulations, Kit Black.
Professor Marth was really into the courtship, huh?
I'm with you, Marth.
Coco is requesting a step away for 1 second. Can I leave for a second?
No, no, we're good, Mom. You can take off. Let me see. Put the dog up on her. Put her. Make chat. Her look really confused.
Okay, because she's aggravated as hell. Okay. She has to do her. Hey, where are you? Coco.
Chat, give it up for my mom.
Wait, I'm one's not in chat.
I mean, you said you're leaving.
She wanted to go out. She usually comes down around 11:30, slaps me upside the head to bring her outside, but now she took off. Okay, never mind.
All right, let's talk about themes. Fast cars, high school.
I like high school.
What else?
Wrestlers.
Like wrestlers are in the movie?
Wrestlers are in the movie.
Wrestlers as actors? Wrestlers
yeah.
as actors.
What about going off of the island theme? Oh, what yep. about
island, yeah.
Kit Black,
I can't see chat. If Kit Black is in, we'd give Kit Black an opportunity to choose a theme. Panwall, you got any ideas? Because I feel like Panwall didn't get any. Panwall is also on a much different scale. So for Panwall to have as many points as he has, or she has, that was back in the day when like Panwall would get like 3 points for winning the entire week. And now it's like 8 points for a week. So, all right, we have Fast Cars, High School, Wrestlers as Actors, Island. And for the last one, Emily, you got something?
Or I thought you yeah, said I have a great one. I did say Island. But I have another one. What about actors who don't need glasses but wear them in a film? Come on. No, I didn't have one.
Kathy, you said you had one on the theme of Island. You had an idea?
Well, what, castaways or, you know, people stuck on islands?
Island is kind of well, encompasses that.
Yeah, that's... Yeah.
Yeah.
What else?
What about, historical trailers, Nate. You okay. love history.
I know, yeah, yeah. I thought you were gonna be like, what about tampons again?
Oh my god, why won't you let tampons be a theme?
What about
feminine hygiene products?
What about movies about weddings. There's
That's fine. That's fine. That there's works.
Five of them.
Oh man. One day we're gonna do tampons 1 week. And the trailers are gonna be great.
Weddings, tampons, they're the same. They're the same.
It essentially. They both involve white poof, you know?
Movies yeah. about
poofy dresses,
video game
cotton.
Programmers.
Yeah.
'90s dark comedies can be good. I think I vibe on the '90s movies a little bit more. I want to.
What
do...
about Learning to Dance movies? That's all. It's just all dance movies. Learning to Dance movies.
One.
Movies where it's no, there's a to bunch. Dance in your town.
Dirty
Oh, we should just
what
do
about
dance
step
movies
up?
Generally.
Yeah, step like up.
That's
dance
what
movies.
I'm saying. Two.
Step Learning up three. Dance
movies. Some of these people are.
Honey.
Know.
Step up four.
No, Magic there Mike. Was only five step ups. They skipped the four, though.
What was the one? There was like Step Up Revolution. There was one about like social unrest.
The FP gets submitted a bunch. All right. Dance movies next time. Okay. Remember that, somebody.
No.
Step.
Well, okay.
AVS Fan 101 says, what are you doing, Step Bro movies?
Step Revolution. Step
yeah. What are you doing, Step Brother? Hello, Step Brother.
Honestly, I feel like there are a lot of step sibling movies, and I'm not talking about porn. There's a lot of step sibling movies where it's like,
Weird Paul's rating.
Weird Paul.
Weird Paul. What a rating.
Weird Paul. Sings. I was Weird Paul Sings.
Watching Weird Paul earlier today.
Oh, whoa.
Not even a goof.
Weird
How
Paul
were the songs
has...
tonight, Weird Paul? Or crowd, Weird Paul crowd.
Hey, Kathy, if Weird you have Paul. Pictures, I don't think you do what? Have them any near us, but Weird Paul has the same haircut that Sam and I had as children. The really? Perfect. The perfect.
The bowl cut.
We were golden. We were golden children, though. We had blonde hair.
You had blonde hair. I know you have
blonde hair AF.
What?
Puppets doll. Wait, oh, Kit Black. Kit Black. We'll have to remember that. Kit Black or she came in with saying puppets / doll movies.
Oh, that's
Ooh,
good.
That's good.
You slept.
That's really good.
You slept.
Is the poll? Oh, it's up.
The poll looks like Wrestlers as Actors is leading with 52%. And
I like
the
that.
Next
what
one
about
back
Actors
is high
as
school.
Wrestlers?
Wrestlers is good. Yeah.
I love how sure. you just have stacks of photos all around the house.
I do.
Like every, I know. Yeah. 1 year for Christmas. Here's what I'll tell you about, well, I'm not saying bad mom, but a little flavor about our mom is last year or the year before, Sam found a closet in our house and he opened it up and it was like every Christmas gift we'd given her, like unopened.
That's not true.
It's a little true. Oh my God. It's a little true. That and some dope shit.
Absolutely.
You know, you true. Have that sous vide is the best sous vide.
I know it is.
Oh, the chat wants to hear your I'm amyl nitrate story.
I'm what? Me doing amyl nitrate? Well, it's good. There's Sam Brown. Can you see that?
No.
Yep.
One of the three wise men.
Oh, he's one of the three wise men?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. He was having a good day. Oh, here's him with Elizabeth.
Loza.
Loza.
Man, did you shave your head?
No,
like a Me? Substitute teacher in that.
One. I know.
Yeah. I can't really see it on the stream.
I know. Sorry.
Yeah, we were talking about bowl cut pictures. You're just getting any picture you can find.
I love it.
She has stacks of photos everywhere.
Babies. So what?
What's up, Marth?
So where was this closet?
Hi, Weird Paul.
The sous vide. I like the sous vide. But I'm just not good at it. Sadly enough, I'm not capable of handling the sous vide. I'm sous vide, not good. No bueno. I can't do it. I did the salmon and it wasn't good. I'm gonna have to.
What's the best Christmas gift we've ever given you?
My goodness. Let me see. Oh.
What was that reaction?
She's trying to change the subject.
No.
It's just a stack.
Oh, look at Santa. He's so cute. What a hot Santa, Kathy. Great point.
Ooh, fat suit movies is also a good idea, Sparky.
Hot Santa. Kathy, also somebody asked, two different people asked on chat if you're single.
Yes, I'm single.
Fat suit movies is good. We'll have to remember.
Mom, are you somebody ready to also mingle? Says, let him know.
Gulio also you says, also take off the condom and insert the carrot into the back of your throat and start using prop comedy to simulate the stem.
What?
Wait, what?
What?
Oh, Nate's sorry. Just reading something.
That was Gulio.
Nate's
I'm just reading, chat
reading
for you.
Something wild. Oh, he's just reading something wild because I was telling. Also, chat was like, ooh, Sam's mom's hot. There was a lot of that. Lot of that.
Guys.
Look how uncomfortable the boys are.
Hey, let's see that picture of me with Santa Claus again.
I think I reached my peak uncomfortability at the fucking strip club when I had to wait in the car.
Oh my god! Really, oh, forget about the annual night.
Oh, we got a dono. Hey Sam, Midnight Blue 2565 donated $10. Said, hey Sam, would you be willing to start uploading Trailer Boys to the YouTube VOD channel? I don't always have time to watch the show on Sunday and would really appreciate it. We'll get him up on YouTube.
Kathy,
I'll start downloading.
Gabagoo thought you were my sister.
Oh, well, nice.
Cute.
What a compliment. Woo!
Cute. Woo! Compliment for me, baby.
Bad casting choices. These are good. Guys, I feel like you could start submitting these as well into the miseryloves.us.
Good.
I just an official Discord channel. Yeah, Marth, we're on that. We're raiding Succubus Sally. Sam can kick that off. Everybody.
Sally.
It's... Hey, thanks to the Weird Paul raid.
Yeah.
I almost called Odd Paul. Weird Paul raid. Sorry that we're ending our show too now. But I think that was really nice. And yeah, we do this every Sunday. Thanks to my mom for coming out.
Yeah, you know what? I appreciate you for hanging in there, Mom. Sam, I think you did a great job doing the technical stuff. Yes. I know it took 6 hours, but we did get it done with just minor. I'll update the leaderboard later.
What?
Oh, you know what? Right. I didn't even update the leaderboard from last week, Panwell. Sorry. It's not automatic.
Congrats.
I do it manually.
Congrats to, was it Kit Black?
Kit Black on the board.
Congrats for getting a win.
So how many people actually?
Oh, hey, there's Weird Paul.
Did this.
How many people watched the show tonight? Yeah. 6,000.
He's fibbing. It was like a few hundred.
That's awesome.
Woo! Isn't that crazy?
Punished Anus says, "Happy Mother's Day, Kathy."
Oh my gosh! Thank you so
That's
much.
That's what I was gonna say,
guys.
You gotta say Punished Anus. You gotta say thank Super you to Punished nice. Anus.
Thank you, Punished Anus. Did I say that wrong?
Somebody clip that.
Penis?
You said it.
Clip it.
No, no. Repronounce the second word. We didn't quite get it. Happy Mother's Day, Kath.
Happy Mother's Day.
Thank you.
Let's do that raid thing.
Love you so much. Happy Mother's Day.
Love you. You want me to step off?
No.
Good night, guys.
Yeah. Oop.
Coming for you, Sally.
This was fun.
Oh, hold on. Let me stop. We're still doing it. And
stay on.